Let me do a short little interview. We're here with one of the best fighters in history, Fernando Vargas. A lot of big fights coming up. Let's start with this one. Triple G Lemieux. Who do you like?
I like Triple G.
Why?
But Lemieux is going to give him definitely a tough fight. And, you know, Lemieux comes to fight, and I think it's going to be a lot more difficult than all his other fights have been.
In all the times I've interviewed you, you've always told me Cotto beats Canelo. What's the reason? Is there a reason behind it, or is it just strictly boxing?
I don't know. Hey, I'm going to be neutral on that fight.
Okay, 50-50. Rios, Bradley, big fight. Hector Munoz, sparring partner of Bradley's here. Your friends were, of course, with Brandon and Robert.
I think Rios has a lot more punching power and a lot more of a pressure fighter than my tocayo Jesse Vargas, and I think that he could end up being able to catch Bradley and maybe even stopping him late rounds.
You won the same Olympic team with Floyd Mayweather. You were like the voice of that team. You were very outgoing. You're Fernando Vargas, charismatic. Mayweather was just starting to get into his personality. How did you see him all of a sudden develop the money Mayweather and the money team?
Well, I mean, he did a great job. You know what I mean? He was able to make himself, liked and also not liked because of the fact that, he's doing all this money stuff. But, hey, you got to take your hat off to him. He's been able to be at the top of the game for over 15 years now. You know what I mean? And he's been really, been able to bring a fighter from, he was from 130 pounds all the way to 154 pounds fighting. And, he doesn't even walk around at 154. He walks around like 145, 47, maybe. And, he's really done a great job. You got to take a hand off.
Last question. What's your favorite memory with a young Floyd Mayweather?
I didn't really hang out with them too much. We're always respectful with one another. Whenever I seen them years after we turned pro, in Vegas, before I lived in Vegas, I saw him at the Magic Convention, and we were walking towards the same way. He came up to me, he hugged me, and I hugged him. And then I went to go see him not too long ago when he was in the fight Pacquiao. I was in the locker room with him, and my kids were like, man, I can't believe we're in the locker room with Floyd. And Floyd was like, man, hey Junior, I heard about you. And Junior was like, wow, Floyd heard about me. And I go, but you got to keep it going. But you got to keep it going if you're going to want to be successful in this game. You can't just, think that you're going to be able to do something without you working hard. Because people are going to gun up to you more. Why? Because you're junior. So right now, I got him in college. Right now, he's in college. Right now, I'm not trying to train him right now. I want him to focus on
degree.
I got him into UNLV. But he's a smart kid himself. He got the Millennium Award, and right now I got him in, and I got his college paid for anyways. Right now he's in UNLV, so I want him to do that. But if he wants to fight later on, then we'll see if we'll go from there.
I gotta ask you this before I forget. Shannon Briggs, were you with the Olympic trainer with Oscar and Robert, and back then when Shannon Briggs was?
Nope.
Do you remember him though when you were younger?
Nope.
Just recently, Let's Go Champ.
Let's Go Champ was, I barely seen it, and I follow him on Instagram. Let's Go Champ. He wants to fight Klitschko.
Yeah. No? What do you think about Klitschko Fury? November 28th, Fury showed up like Batman. Your press conferences, nobody showed up like Batman. It was really like.
I didn't even get to see that. I don't even know what you're talking about right now.
Tyson Fury showed up at a press conference dressed like Batman to try to promote the fight.
Who did?
Tyson Fury from England. We don't know about him much over here, but he's big out there.
Okay. Well.
Fernando Vargas, who's the best fighter in history? Is it Floyd Mayweather or someone else?
Best fighter in history, man. I got a few ones that I love. Sugar Ray Robertson was no joke. I love the boxing style. My idol, Gran Campeón Mexicano, Julio César Chávez. So yes, it's difficult, man. Because of the fact that look at Sugar Ray Robinson, what he did. He fought like I don't know how many fights. Like
140, 150, 160. Yeah.
And he was just a savage, man. He might have lost him, but look at all the stuff that I'm fighting 15 rounds and meticulous, just the intelligence and power in both hands. And I love this boxing ability. And then you have Chavez, my idol, pressure fighter that had a solid chin and nothing hurt him. talking to me, because, hey, you know, he just put that pressure, you couldn't keep him off you. And that's why he was able to knock out so many people. So it's just difficult.
Before I forget, there's always arguments in the gym between Robert and Brandon. When they sparred, who won the sparring? Do you remember sparring Robert, and who won the sparring?
Hey, I used to spar Robert, ask him.
He told me once that you sparred your dad, and he came in and that you didn't go easy on him.
Well, I mean, Vato's never been part of my life, you know what I mean? So, you know, he came in one day trying to yell, I don't know if he was high or drunk, but he came in trying to yell, like, oh, you do this, do that. I'm like, oh, get the gloves on, put the gloves on, and show me.
And you dropped them.
And I dropped them, and I told him to get up. And then I said, get up. You know, I said a few derogatory words, but hey, he's lucky that I talked to him. We're just friends, and you're lucky that I right now I'm not talking to him, but you know, you're lucky that I forgave you, because I'm a Christian man, and you know, and I follow Christ, because I want to be forgiven for my sins. Though I'm not perfect, but you know, the thing is this, you know, I don't have a relationship with him at all. And I'm not gonna have a relationship with them if you're doing drugs around my family, around my kids. If I don't do it, you're not gonna do that in front of my kids. I'm not.
Fernando Vargas, everyone should follow you at _Fernando Vargas. Your reality show is returning on a different network. It was very entertaining. I see your father-in-law over here, your kids over here. What channel do we see? Part two?
Follow Instagram at tuyo.
T-U?
At T. At underscore. I don't know, at TU_YO.
TU_YO, there you have it, Fernando Vargas. Hey, how's it going? And the pals in Oxnard, right, congratulations on the great performance that your team had.
Thank you, man.
Mac, how do you feel going back to Oxnard now as a trainer? Fun?
It's a beautiful thing. You know what I mean? I go over there as a trainer, it's a beautiful thing. I was able to have a great time, see a lot of different people that I've not seen in a long time. And I love it.
There you have it, Fernando Vargas, _Fernando Vargas, FusionReport.com. I'm Melissa Bragg reporting.